Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Olha Nishkumai.
And here is the Dr. Volodymyr Chernykh. We welcome you to this European Wellness Health Series, where we'll dive deep into the world of medicine, diseases and disorders, exploring the latest in their prevention, cutting-edge treatments and
groundbreaking research in biological regenerative medicine to help you stay informed and healthy. Today, we are discussing a critical topic in cerebrovascular health, stroke.
Let's dive right in, Dr. Olga. So why is stroke such a significant issue in the realm of cerebrovascular diseases?
Cerebrovascular and cardiovascular diseases are the world number one killers. Both type of illnesses happen mainly due to atherosclerosis complication. The main stroke risk factor are metabolic disorder, high blood pressure, obesity, diabetes mellitus, and decrease in kidney functioning.
And harmful habits, right?
And harmful habits like smoking and alcohol consumption can worsen also the patient condition. It is crucial to discuss the problem of stroke because it is one of the leading causes of morbidity and mortality worldwide. It affects millions of people each year and can result in severe disability or even death. By the way, what do all these famous people share? What is common for all these famous persons? Well, they all had the same cause of death. Stalin, Churchill, Dumas, all of them passed away due to stroke. Essentially, there are two main types of stroke, ischemic and hemorrhagic. Ischemic strokes are caused by a blockage in blood vessel supply in the brain. After, due to atherosclerosis or cardioembolism due to different kind of arrhythmias, like atrial fibrillation or flutter.
Yeah, I'd like to add that hemorrhagic strokes, on the other hand, occur when a blood vessel in the brain ruptures, okay? So, leading to bleeding within or around the brain tissue. Both types of a stroke can have devastating effects, but their management and prevention strategies can differ significantly.
Absolutely. But before discussing the management, I think we should say a few words about the pathogenesis of stroke.
Yeah, that's right.
So, ischemic stroke usually results from a clot obstructing the blood flow to part of the brain, causing the tissue damage and loss of function. The underlying causes often include high blood pressure, diabetes, and unhealthy lifestyle habits like smoking and excessive alcohol consumption.
And hemorrhagic stroke is often linked to high blood pressure, which can weaken blood vessel walls and making them so. It just makes them prone to rupture. Then aneurysms or arteriovenous malformations can also exacerbate the condition. The key here is managing blood pressure effectively to reduce the risk. Dr. Olga, could you please share your expertise in examining patients with possible stroke diagnosis?
Sure. Diagnosis is crucial. First of all, we need to be aware of the following signs. The abbreviation BFAST is pretty much helpful for goals for B, loss of balance, E letter means blurred vision, F, one side of the face is dropping, A, arm or leg weakness, S, speech difficulty, T, time to call for ambulance immediately. If you spot someone who has one or a few of the signs mentioned, please do call for ambulance immediately. Also, medical professionals use CT scans or MRIs to determine the type of stroke and its location.
Okay, so let's talk about the available options for stroke treatment in conventional medicine.
Well, traditional immediate treatment in case of ischemic stroke may include thrombolysis to dissolve the clot and antiplatelet agents, while hemorrhagic strokes often require surgical intervention to stop the bleeding and relieve pressure of the brain. Lipid-lowering medication is also necessary, along with the management of primary comorbidities, such as hypertension and, of course, lifestyle adjustment is something people who are at risk of stroke should do. However, I must mention that no conventional therapies can restore the damaged brain tissue. For this reason, Dr. Volodymyr, I would like your opinion regarding the bioregenerative methods for treat brain damage following a stroke.
Well, there is growing interest in regenerative medicine, mainly stem cell therapy, as a supportive treatment after stroke. And I'd like, of course, I'd like to draw our viewers' attention to that. Stem cell therapy offers great potential to repair damaged brain tissues. It involves the implantation of various types of stem cells that can potentially and will regenerate and replace the cells in the affected area, supporting their recovery. In European wellness, not only we do have hundreds of different types of organic specific targeted stem cells, but we also have nearly 70 types of brain specific targeted stem cells as well. Complementing stem cell therapy, we have some extra tools. So there are several peptide-based treatments and supplements. Mitochondrial and nano CNS peptides, or sometimes we call it brain peptides, all right, can enhance cellular energy production and overall cell function, and they support tissue repair and regeneration at the, you know, molecular level, which is crucial in the recovery process. Another fascinating fact is that exosomes are also being explored as a supportive therapy for stroke patients. There's a small, tiny vesicles that facilitate communication between cells, delivering essential proteins and genetic material. Exosomes derived from stem cells enhance the body's regenerative capacity and aid in stroke recovery, reducing apoptosis, promoting angiogenesis and urogenesis, modulating the immune response, etc. Additionally, there are specialized supplements that can support recovery and prevent further strokes, because prevention is the best treatment. For example, MF3's plaques helps clear plaque buildup in arteries, preventing atherosclerosis and promoting cardiovascular health. Longevity Essentials and GI Proenzyme Symbiotic are supplements designed to support overall health and immune function, which are absolutely crucial during recovery.
100%. Forearm is forearm. Precautions are crucial. Patients should focus on primary prevention, maintaining a healthy diet, regular exercise, and avoiding smoke and excessive alcohol. Primary and secondary prevention includes managing blood pressure, cholesterol, and glucose level, as well as medication like lipid-lowering and antiplatelet medicine for high-risk group patients.
Indeed. Knowledge is incredible power, Dr. Olga, and education of the patients is essential as well. Well, let's summarize the key points, the key takeaways. Stroke, of course, now we know, and it's always been, it's a significant health issue that impacts individuals and healthcare systems significantly. Early diagnosis and appropriate treatment are vital. While conventional treatments are practical, non-conventional approaches, including regenerative therapies and supplementation, show tremendous promise. And prevention is always better than a cure. But remember, before incorporating any new medication or supplement into your routine, it is important to consult with your trusted healthcare provider.
Absolutely. Understanding stroke risk factor and maintaining a healthy lifestyle are the best defenses. Thank you for joining us today. Please like, share, and subscribe if you found this video helpful. And don't forget to leave your questions in the comments below.
Yes, we are waiting for them. Thank you so much. See you next time, and stay healthy, please.
See you.
See you.